My name is Marilu Knode. I'm the executive director of Lyle Meyer Sculpture Park and the Aronson Endowed Professor of Modern and Contemporary Art History at the University of Missouri, St. Louis. And I think that this joint appointment suggests the leadership role St. Louis academic and cultural supporters have played in making explicit the connection between the humanities and the arts. Lyle Meyer Sculpture Park is a cultural landscape where art frames, explores, and comments upon our relationship to our built and natural environments. Our exhibition and educational programs explore social structures, human culture, contemporary life, and how it has been shaped by our past. Questions we ask ourselves at Lyle Meyer include, how can we use our 105 acres to drive a critically inspired discussion about a new social contract? And can the arts help create an informed and responsive citizenry? We have up right now a thematic show called Camp Out, Finding Home in an Unstable World, and it's part of our series organized under the rubric Archaeology of Place. Our goal is to apply an artistic lens to the urgent topics of our contemporary world. Camp Out looks at the impact of immigration on communities, stewardship of the land and its resources, how community is produced through food, how homelessness is a natural and a man-made disaster, the history of land exploitation and exhaustion in this region. At the heart of the show is an examination of the first waves of suburban flight that took place in the early 20th century and how that's impacted subsequent urban growth in St. Louis. And so it's not just artists that we bring to Lyle Meyer. We also have experts who have joined in our educational programming, including Jay Swoboda of What's Up Magazine and the Homeless Empowerment Project in St. Louis. And What's Up Magazine produces a publication that homeless people sell, and it's a different edition around the country. Sarah McCabe, who runs the Point Youth Shelter. Lindsay Kingsland, who is the Associate Director of Webster University's Institute for Human Rights. And Sean Thomas, the Executive Director of Old North St. Louis Restoration Group. And this group in 2011 received the Environmental Protection Agency's Office of Sustainable Communities Award for Overall Excellence in Smart Growth. So again, Lyle Meyer is using our land as a platform for this kind of discussion. An exhibition we have coming up next year, I'll use as another example, is called The River Between Us, and it's a project organized with Longview House and Gardens in New Orleans, an historic house whose founders had deep roots in the civil rights movement in the South. The show will explore the scars of slavery, discrimination, and civil strife in both communities, and track the resonance between the cities with underlying history of Native American, French, English, and African American cultures. And joining us in articulating these issues of relevance will be Dr. Richard Campanella, Tulane University, who write about intertwined histories of river exploration and the growth in New Orleans. We do extensive K-12 education and make sure that these topics, these humanity topics, radiate throughout our programming. Of course, our K-12 focuses on building social skills, cognitive development, and skills in the arts, nature, science, and math to meet Missouri state standards. Our partners include almost 150 schools in St. Louis County, another 122 schools in underserved communities in St. Louis City, and we partner with groups such as the Desley Collaborative Vision for the Performing Arts. And we take about 15,000 students and adults in our paid programs throughout the year. But the question would be, how do we measure our impact in the community? We know that there's a resonance beyond the park in the lives, minds, and hearts of our visitors through our visitor surveys and our community feedback. And there's some very specific qualities to Lyle Meyer that yields results beyond what most contemporary arts organizations can generate. We are one, free to the public year-round. We're a park, we're 105 acres. We have a very general audience. And we have 300,000 people who come to the park a year, and I think that's a slight underestimation because we have no fence around the park and people walk by every day. Their dogs poop in our yard every day. And we've had over 1 million people come and enjoy Lyle Meyer over the last 35 years. And this statistic alone suggests how broadly our themes are disseminated throughout the community. Direct life impact is another way that we have been gathering impact that we have in the community. And I'll just show two examples from Laumeier. Karen Wolf grew up in Sunset Hills. She was very inspired by Laumeier. She is currently the public arts administrator in Madison, Wisconsin. And I met her recently at an opening, and she said, "I was shocked when I went to other cities and realized they did not have an asset like Laumeier," which made us very proud. And then Phil Sline was in Laumeier's first camp program in 1980. And as many of you may know, Phil is today a successful art dealer in the city of St. Louis. So my conclusion would be, for our contribution to the humanities relevance to our community, is that our staff produces programs that engages audience in topics of relevance to their lives by inviting the best contemporary artists from around the globe to highlight our common humanity. Thank you.